Good evening, everyone. 大家好，晚上好。在亚洲的人，现在是中午时间。 So welcome to our Sunday evening lecture series. 欢迎大家来参加我们今天晚上的演讲系列。那今天是轮到静勇，这边和大家结法缘。So it's my turn, 静勇 to share some dharma with you. And so today I'd like to discuss with you the song in praise of the Sangha by an emperor in the Qing Dynasty. His name is Shun. 那今天我想和大家一起来讨论这个清朝顺治皇帝的赞成歌。 I think everybody know that the CDDB is the Guanyin Bodhisattva's called the Bodhimanda. 那我想很多人都晓得万国城是观音菩萨的道场。就在我们的大殿里头，就有这么一尊很庄严的观音像。 We have this very adorned Guanyin image right in the Buddha hall. And it's also we have the Guanyin sessions three times a year. 那我们在圣城呢，每一年有打三个观音期。那第一个是在春天的时候，这个都是阴历二月十九号，是观音菩萨的圣诞。So the first one is in the springtime. We follow the lunar calendar. So this is the second lunar month. On the 19th day, the second lunar month, we celebrate Guanyin Bodhisattva's birthday. Then in the summer, we celebrate his enlightenment. 那到夏天的时候，我们就庆祝观音菩萨的成道。我们上次打观音期就是在庆祝观音菩萨成道，那也有在线上第一次和线上，大家让大家参加。 Last time we have the Guanyin session was exactly this one to celebrate Guanyin's enlightenment. And that was the first time we have the online and sharing live streaming of the event, everyone. 那今天开始呢，我们是第三个观音期，这个是因为庆祝观音菩萨的出家日。 So this morning we started another session, third one in the year. This one we celebrate Guanyin Bodhisattva. We usually call the living the householder's life. He became a monk on the 19th day of the ninth lunar month. 阴历的话是9月19号，是在星期三。 So this is the actual day will be Wednesday. So because of this occasion, so I chose to talk about the song in praise of the Sangha. 就是因为这个因缘，所以我选择和大家来讨论这个赞声歌。 This is taken from the Astor Sutra commentary by the Vinaya Master. 这个是从上人地藏菩萨《地藏菩萨本愿经》的开示里头、前世里头拿出来的。我们是集成一本书，叫《地狱不空》这本书。 Couldn't find my. Usually I can find the, couldn't find the laser pointer. Okay, 就是有人这样问上人，我想孝顺父母，但是我现在已经出家了，那父亲母亲都不在我身边，那我要怎么样孝顺? So this is a disciple, I think it's either a monk or nun. He asked the master that, I want to be filial to my parents. However, now I'm a monastic, and my parents are not actually live very far away from me. So how can I be filial to them? The answer was, becoming a monastic is a practice of great filiality. 上人回答就说你出家呢那真是个大孝。 另外他讲说那个所谓的义子出家呢，九祖升天。 There's a saying that the nine generations of ancestors were sent to the heavens when one child becomes a monk or nun. 那就是你九祖呢会借你的光而升天。 所以你这个不单孝顺今世的父母，过去的祖先，过去的父母，你都孝顺了。So you are filial not just to your parents of this life, also to your parents in the past. So that's why it's saying that the nine generation of ancestors were sent to the heavens. However, there's a condition. 有个条件的，不是说出家就九祖会升天，你必须要修行。你如果不修行的话，九祖不会升天；如果修行的话，那就是个大孝，将父母亲都超度的。So you're becoming a monk or nun, you don't cultivate, then your ancestor won't ascend to the heavens. It's only when you cultivate heart, you'll be able to save your parents, which is a practice of great fidelity. So this tells us that become a monastic is really a filial thing to do. 那这个就是告诉我们说出家其实是个大孝。 Now, I think everybody knows that Shakyamuni Buddha was a prince. Right? 那我们大家都晓得这个释迦牟尼佛 原来是个王子来的。那不光是释迦牟尼佛是这样子，这个安世高法师也是一个太子。 And it's not only Shakyamuni Buddha, this great master, Anshigao was also a prince. Okay? And the famous one, this is the first picture, Chan School Bodhidharma, he was also a prince. 那大摩祖师这个出家的，还有很出名的梁武帝，他其实想要出家的三次，不过又回去了，就还出去了。 Emperor Liang, I think people familiar with him. He tried to become a monk three times. Actually, he went to became a monk for three times, but then he disrobed again. So at least he tried three times. 那今天要讲的就是这个顺治皇帝。 And today we're going to talk about the Emperor Shun. He was in the 17th century. 清朝初年的第一个皇帝。 And last century, there was a Thai prince who also became a monk, very famous monk. His name is so long, I can't say that. 那上个世纪泰国有个王子也出家了，就是成了一个很有名的出家人。他这个名字很长，泰国人的名字很长很长。 不懂得怎么念。那上人水镜回天录里头有讲到这个清世祖，就是顺治皇帝。The Vena Master wrote a series of stories, commentaries. It's compiled as the reflection in water and mirrors. And 讲说这个出家呢是不容易的事情，不要说是天子，就是普通老百姓，也看不破放不下，舍不得出家。 So he said that renouncing the household life is not an easy thing to do, not to mention an emperor. Even ordinary people cannot do it. They cannot let go, cannot see through. And 我来讲，就这个身为天子能够舍荣国出家，这都是有大善根的人。所以说，出家者乃大乘无士，为将相所能为也。 So it said that an emperor who can renounce national glory and become a monk is one who has exceptional roots of goodness. And it said that renouncing the householder's life is a feat of a great hero. Even generals and ministers cannot do it. 这是孙子皇帝的画像, this is the Emperor Shun. This is 根据上人的解释, this is follow the Vinaya Master's commentary. 他的名字叫福林, 6岁的时候就入关称帝, 这个入是那个山海关称帝, 年号是顺治。 这是清朝入关以后的第一个皇帝，他在位有18年的时间。 His given name was Fulin. We have lived the man here whose name also Fulin, but the character is different. 我们这里有一个居士，他也叫福林，不过这个名字是不一样。 He was proclaimed an emperor at the age of 6. Just like a little kid, okay? After their troops entered China, and his reign period was Shun Zi. That's how we call the Emperor Shun Zi. He was on the throne for 18 years. And according to the official record, he died at age 24. 这个正史上呢记载就是说他是 18岁，24岁的时候就病逝，说是得染到了天花。So there was a sort of an epidemic as well, virus, smallpox. It was recorded, and he was infected with that and died at age 24. This is official record, but whether he really died, it's a big mystery. 这个是不是真正的20岁就病逝呢？这是一个很谜啊。他说我那时候就死的话，就没有故事好讲了。So this is the China the map. This is usually what we call Manchuria. And in Chinese, we call the northeast, because it's northeast of China. And the Qing Dynasty, the Manchuria, they came from this area. Okay, and so they enter China, become occupied China, become the Qing Dynasty. Now, 我们大家都晓得这个满洲。 满人呢，原来就在东边，他们是入关，入什么关呢？入的这个山海关，在这边山海关。This is the Great Wall, and when the Great Wall made the sea, there's a pass, and this pass is not easy to pass through, but there was a general Ming Dynasty. He sort of let the Qing, the Man and troops enter. And once they enter, they refuse to leave. So they occupied the China that way. 那大家都晓得这个吴三桂就是开的这个山海关让清军进来。 已经来以后就满洲人就不走了，就站着中国，那就这样的成了清朝。但是他在这个是上文讲的，就是他在顺治皇帝在24岁的时候，就对玉林国师讲说，我是在想学这个，我想到释迦如来，释迦如佛陀呢，释迦牟尼佛，他死王位而成正觉，那达摩出主呢弃王位而成祖师，我呢我要效仿他。 So at age 24, Emperor Shunzi told the National Master Yulin, Shakyamuni Buddha renounced his royal court and became a Buddha. The first patriarch, Bodhidharma, gave up his throne and became a patriarch. I want to emulate them. Okay. 那就是显然他是有那个要出家的 the Shangfa. So the obvious from this, we know that he really wanted to become a monk. And so, so this is the thing that he was 18 years old, he was 18 years old. He was in the Wutaishan, Wutaishan, he 他的儿子呢，康熙皇帝听说这个他父亲在五台山，所以故意到五台山去访问，想去找他的父亲，找了三次，没有找到人。He was on the throne for 18 years before he disappeared. Of course, the first history recorded that he died, but actually he wasn't dead. And the story, the legend said that he became a monk in Mount Wutai. This is a five peak mountain. This, of course, was not recorded in history. His son, Emperor Kangxi, heard about it and he visited the mountain, Mount Wutai, three times. Tried to look for his father, but he couldn't find him. 但是呢，他遇到一个 一个和尚，这个和尚告诉他说，他的名字叫巴查。 And he met a monk whose name was 巴查. What does it mean? 这个中文里头，中国字父亲上头是巴，对不对？下头是查，那分开来就是巴查。那你把巴查合起来的话，就是个父。 And this is a Chinese character, father. And the top two stroke is eight. And the bottom part is cha, just that X. So if you put this part on top of this part and become fu, become a father. And this his son couldn't figure that out. And so he failed to recognize his father. 但是这个康熙皇帝呢，不认识，不晓得这个就是他的父亲，所以错过这个父子相认的机会。So that's a pity. 那接下来我们就来看看这个顺治皇帝的战神歌。 上文是叫做战神诗， and we call it song in praise of the Sangha. However, the Venerable Master call it a poem. Okay. Excuse me for a minute. I think I want to do something. I want to do a new share. Okay. 给我一分钟，我要重新 share 一下。 Okay, doesn't really help. So we can recite it together. If like, you know Chinese and the English translation is here. 天下丛林泛四川，波雨到处任君餐。黄金白玉归为贵，唯有袈裟披肩难。 The food in the mountains throughout the world piles up as high as a mountain. So monks with arms round balls can receive food as they please. Gold and jade, in fact, are not precious. The sash is the rarest garment one can wear. 这个就是讲说天下就是世界的丛林，丛林就指的寺庙，寺庙里头的饭呢，像山一样高，你不用担心挨饿。那钵盂到处任君餐，这个出家人只要有个钵的话，你到什么寺庙里去的话，都不会被拒之门外，都可以用斋。 So the first time I say that the food in the mountains throughout the world piles up as high as a mountain. So there are plenty of food in the mountains. And any monk with armed balls can receive food in any monastery, okay, as they please. 我接下来讲说黄金呢，白玉会为贵。黄金呢，白玉。 不是那么贵重的东西，虽然世俗人认为很贵，什么东西才更贵重呢？袈裟披肩难，就是说出家呢是非常难的事情，更难得的事情，比这个黄金白玉都来得贵重。Gold and jade are not precious, even though we all think it's precious, but it's not. What's most rare is the sash, precise sash. Becoming a monk is rare than this gold and jade is treasures. Cheng Wei Da Di San He Zhu, Yu Guo Yu Min Shi Zhuan Pan, Bai Nian San Wan Liu Qian Ri. 不及身家半日闲, I, the emperor, am lord of the land with its mountains and rivers. I worry over the nation. I'm concerned for the people. I'm always distressed. 100 years or 36,000 days as emperor can't compare with the ease of half a day as a monk. 他就讲说他自己呢, 是这个山河大地的主人呢，整个中国的主人。但是呢，他担心这个国家，担心人民，事情很烦。So he was emperor. He's the lord of the land. Has rivers, mountains. However, he worried about the country, about people. He was always distressed. 百年三万六千日，一百年呢是三万六千日，当皇帝呢，比不上出家人半日的清闲悠闲。So 100 years as emperor cannot compare with the ease of half a day as a monk. So he really liked to be a monk. Because he think, and even as emperor for 100 years, it cannot compare with being a monk for just half a day. 所以他真的是很羡慕出家，就是皇帝当了一百年，也比不上出家个半日。来时糊涂去时迷，空在人间走这回。 未曾生我，谁是我？生我之时，我是谁？I came to this life confused. I leave it deluded. I've come to this world as a human in vain. Before I was born, who was I? At the time of my birth, who was I then? 所以来时糊涂呢，就是我们生的时候是糊涂的，来生出生投胎，去死迷，就是我们一口气不来以后，也是糊里糊涂走的。那如果是这样的话，就在走到这人间这么一趟啊，空走了一趟。 So usually we came to this world confused. We just came, and because of karma, we have no control. And if when we die, we also die deluded, then we came to this world in vain, right? 接下来就是未曾生我，谁是我？还没有出生之前，我是谁？ 那生我的时候，我出生了以后，我又是谁？ So before I was born, who was I? At the time of my birth, who was I then? This is like a, we call it a topic that you investigate during the Chan. 这是我们一般禅期的时候，参禅的时候的话头。 就是我们经常会讲说，父母未生之前的本来面目是什么？就是这个未曾生我，谁是我？So, there's a common topic people investigate is that, what did I look like before I was born to my parents? So this is this topic here. 长大成人方是我，何言朦胧又是谁？不如不来也不去，来时欢喜去是悲。After growing up, my identity was final set. Then when I shut my eyes at death, who will I become? Coming to life cannot compare to no coming nor going. We are happy at birth and sad at death. 今天就是长大以后呢，才是我，才是我现在的我。但是呢，当你把眼睛一合起来以后，那又是谁？又到哪里去了？所以这些问题就是我们一般人都没有见到。So after growing up, then you become now. Okay. However, when you close your eyes. At death, who will you become? These are the questions we need to ask ourselves all the time. Yeah. 那不如不来又不去，所以比不上不来又不去。这不来又不去，就是你已经了生脱死了，就不会来了。不来的话就不会去，就是说，脱了轮回，不如这样子。 So coming to life cannot compare to no coming nor going. If you are not born, then you won't need to live, right? This is talking about ending birth and death. And you ending birth and death, then you don't need to come again. Just like the fourth stage arhat, they don't come to worry anymore. So 然后接下来讲说来时欢喜去世悲，这个是大家都了解的。生家里头生孩子的时候，生小孩子大家都很高兴，但是家里头有人往生的时候，一般世俗人就很悲伤。So this is very common that everybody so happy when you have a newborn, a baby born into the family. When you have someone die in the family, everybody would be very sad, right? That's usually the case. <clears throat> Happiness and sadness meeting and departing cause much trouble and grief? Who knows when we will attain true ease? Yet if you could fathom the monastic life, and even today turn your head around, it would not be too late. 所以悲欢我们人世间就有伤心的时候有高兴的时候你离开的时候就悲伤相聚的时候高兴有很多的忧虑勤劳等到哪一天才能够清闲 okay? So we sometimes happy, sometimes we are sad. When friends, families, relatives meet, we are very happy. When someone is going to leave, then we feel sad. Okay? And this causes a lot of trouble and grief. And who knows when we'll be attain true ease. Okay? 若能了达身家事，如果能够真的了解这个出家这件事情的话， 从此回头不算迟，就是说，出家不管你什么时候出家，都不算晚。 Okay, so if you could fathom the monastic life, even today, turn your head around, you would not be too late. In other words, it's never too late to become a monk or become a nun. Okay. No one in the world can compare with monastics, being carefree, worry-free, peace of mind. Their mouth savors the pure flavor of serenity. Their bodies always done the 100 patched rope. 世界上没有可以比得上出家人，出家人怎么样？无忧无虑，得安逸。出家人没有忧愁，没有担心的东西，没有担心的事情，很安详，很自在。 So no one in the world can compare with monastics, being carefree, worry-free, and peace of mind. 口中吃的清和味，那我们出家人吃的就是很清淡的东西，身上常常穿的就是袈裟，这就是白衲衣，因为从前的袈裟是一块一块补起来的。 So the monastic's mouth savors the pure flavor of serenity, and their body always wear the 100 pass robe, because the sash is supposed to make up many patches of clothes stitched together. 他这边讲说这个出家人是无忧无虑得安逸，这个当然不一定是每个人都是这样子，理想上希望是这样子。 Okay? So was here say that the monastic are carefree, worry-free, and this may not be true to everyone. Okay, so it's not for sure every monk, nun are like that. So carefree and worry-free. Wuhu si hai wei shang ke, jie ying su shi zhong pu ti. 个个都是真罗汉、毗达如来、三等一 They are received as honored guests everywhere they wander, within the five lakes and the four seas. All because in past lives they resolved upon Bodhi. Genuine arhats always wear the Tathagata's three ropes on their bodies. I finally found a laser pointer. 这边讲到五湖四海为上客，这个中国内陆有五个大湖，四海就是指的东边这边，南边有四个海，指的就是天下，就是在中国本土，你到处去都是当做贵宾。那为什么会这样子？因为术士所种的菩提，过去生。 生生很多生都种了菩提，所以这辈子才有这样的福报。 So here it says they receive as honor guests everywhere they wander within the five lakes and four seas. The five lakes are talking about the mainland China has five big lakes, just like in US, there are big lakes. And China has five big lakes. And the four seas are talking about the seas in the east and the south. Okay? In other words, it's talking about the whole country. The monastic is always received as honored guests everywhere throughout the country. Why is that? Because they resolve upon Bodhi throughout many lives in the past. 那接下来讲说，个个都是真罗汉，毗达如来三等一。这个讲的是，我想是言之过，想他大概还没有出家，所以他认为这个每个出家人都是罗汉，阿罗汉来的。其实真的要成阿罗汉不是件容易的事情。毗达如来三等一，这是真的，就是我们，就是他。 有大衣，我们有善衣。So genuine arhats always wear the Tathagatas three robes on their bodies. Not every monk are arhat yet. Actually, most of us are not enlightened, and we are not arhat yet. I think Emperor Shun Zi, when he wrote this, he probably was still a lay person, and he mentioned that he perceived that every monk are arhat, which actually is not the case. But it's true that we always wear the, we have three robes. We have to put on three robes on our bodies. Jingwu, Yu Tu, Dong Fu Xi, Wei Ren Qian Mu, Yong Xin Ji. Bai Nian Shi Shi San Qing Meng, Wan Li Qian Kun, Yu Ji Qi. While the golden crow and the jade hare run from east to west, we must refrain from exercising our cleverness. Worldly affairs done over a century last no longer than a fleeting dream at midnight. The mirror vials of land is but a game of chess. 这边讲的金乌玉兔东乌西，有没有人知道什么是金乌，什么是玉兔？从东到西，这个玉兔我想比较容易知道，这个是兔子，就是月亮。 那金乌的指的太阳，就太阳里头听说有这乌鸦在，所以这个就是讲太阳和月亮从东边升起，然后从西边下山去。那为人呢，切莫用心机，就我们当人呢，不要用我们的心机来盘算。So it says the golden crow and the jet hare run from east to west. I think an English speaker probably don't know what golden crow is, what jade hare is. Jade hare is the moon. It's in Chinese legend, say that there's a hare in the moon. So when you look at the moon, is so something there looks like a hair pounding medicine, and that's why I'm called it jet hair. That's why jet hair is talking about the moon. And Chinese also believe there was a crow in the middle of the sun. That's why it's called the golden crow with the sun. So the sun and the moon rise from in the east and set in the west, right? So we must refrain from exercising our cleverness. So don't try to be smart to take a branch of people. 百年世事三经梦，百年的世事就是指的我们人生能够活百年够长了，就是这个可以说你一辈子呢，等于是像你半夜的一场梦一样，那么短的时间，嗯，万里乾坤，乾坤就是天下，它的大地就是整个大地。 也不过像一局棋那样的大小。So worldly affair done over a century lasts no longer than a fleeting stream at midnight. So a century is probably, I think your lifespan is probably not everyone can live up to 100 years. So this can be seen that your one life is now no longer than a fleeting dream at midnight. Very short, life is so short. And the mere miles of land is but a game of chess. This is the earth of the China, the whole country, even though it's big, but it's just but a game of chess. So so he looked at the life is very short and the country is very small, something. 这个就是讲的金乌，这个我们的传说里头也许知道比较少，就是黑乌鸦在红日中间，这个乌鸦呢有三只脚，叫金乌。So this is a crow that has 3 feet. Legend say that there's a crow in the sun, so it's called the golden crow represent the sun. And see the hair pounding medicine in the moon. And that's why it's called the jade moon hair. 这个兔子我想大家比较熟悉，兔子在那边捣药，所以这个玉兔就指的是月亮。 禹开九州汤方杰，侵吞六国汉登基，古来多少英雄汉，南北山头沃土泥。禹, the great, set up the 9 states, but his descendant, King Jay, was expelled by King Tang. Country Qin swallowed the other 6 nations. But soon the Han Dynasty overthrew it. From ages past, all the great heroes who now lie on the mountain beneath the dirt and mud. 这个中国历史，大禹是开九州，但是他这个夏朝的最后一个皇帝，唐的夏桀王。 被商汤王给放逐，就是结束了夏朝。秦国呢并吞了六国，这是战国时代并六国，统一中国。后来呢，很快就被汉朝给推翻掉。So this is the transition. This King Yi set up the 9 states long time ago, and his descendant King Jie and was really not a good king. He was expelled by King Tang. And country Qin defeated the other six nations in the warring period, China. And very soon, the Han Dynasty took over it. 古来多少英雄汉, 从古到现在有那么多的英雄, 现在怎么样? 都在南北山头国土里, 都是埋在山头, 埋在地底下, 是不是? So from ages past, all the great heroes who now lie on the mountain beneath the dirt and mud. There are many, many heroes since the ancient. However, they all now lie on the mountain beneath the dirt and mud. So in this, 不管你有多少的丰功伟业, 到头来还是一场梦, 还是埋在土里头。 So no matter how great you were in this life, at the end, you are still under the dirt mud. Huang Pao, 换得紫袈裟, 只为当年一年茶, 我本西方一纳子, 为何身在帝王家? I replaced the yellow robe with the priestess sash, or because of one confused thought in the past. I used to be a monk in the West. How did I end up being born into a royal family? 就讲他皇帝的穿的是皇袍，要换成袈裟。他只是因为从前的一念茶， 一念起了错误的想法， 他本来是在印度西方的一个出家人， 结果呢， 这辈子升到帝王家来。 So you want to replace the yellow robe with the emperor's robe, it's yellow, with priestess ash. He used to be a monk in the West. However, all because of one confused thought in the past lives. Now he ended up being born into a royal family. So he knew that his past life, so this tells us that he knew that he was a monk in his past life. For 18 years, I have not known a day of freedom. To attack the south, to conquer the north, with no end in sight. I'm now putting down everything and heading for the west. I don't care whether the regime will last a thousand or a million years. 他在位18年，他非常不自由，到处南征北讨，没有止境的时候。因为他是那个第一任皇帝，刚进到中国来，他要把中国整个占领，不容易的事情。那时候有很多各地的土匪啦，军队。 所以要把整个中国给平息的，不是这么回事的事情。他18年来就是到处在出兵，所以他很辛苦的。So he was on the throne for 18 years. Since he was the first emperor entering the China, and China at that time had lots of armies, robbers, bandits everywhere. So they have to try to defeat all these armies, these bandits. So for 18 years, he never had a day of rest, no freedom. So it's fighting everywhere. 他现在呢，杀手西方去，他不管了，他放手了，不管这些东西，他往西方去，不管这个春秋与晚秋，秋就是年的意思，就不管这个清朝为有1000年之久呢，还是10000年之久，不管他了，他走了。So now he want to put down everything and heading for west. He doesn't care whether the dynasty will last 1,000 or 10,000 years. So this is the end of the poem or the song. 那这个战胜歌是就到此为止。 This is a praise written by the Venerable Master. 这是上人写的赞。说梦中富贵呢，尽礼荣华，迷途忘返，远离本家。一旦觉悟，必喜天下，自在西归，披紫袈裟。We all stand honor in a dream, splendor and glamour in a mirror. On the wrong track, forgetting to return. And far away from his home. Once awakened, he regards the country as a worn-out sleeper. And he aspired to return to the West, clad in the purple sash. 这个等于就是讲的梦里头的富贵了，还有镜里的荣华，那让他就是迷途忘返。但是他觉悟以后，他就把这个 天下当作一个坏掉的拖鞋一样丢掉它，然后叫西归，披上紫袈裟。So this is talking about the past, what he was forgotten, forgotten his far away from his home. And once he awakened, he regarded the country as a worn-out sleeper, and he aspired to return to the West and becoming a monk. I think we are coming in sort of short of time. I want to skip some of the This is a commentary. 这是上人在讲十力品的时候，让我讲的。他说：“这个末道出家容易得，皆因累世种菩提。” Don't ever say that it's easy to become monastic. So, due to planting body life after life. 那最低限度呢，要有个决心，要把父母、妻子、兄弟姐妹、朋友都放下，富贵功名。 要抛弃, so you need to have a great resolve, letting go of your parents, wife, kids, brothers, friends, fame, honor, and wealth. Okay. 跟大家分享一首这个罗庄严的行事诗. I want to share with everyone with this poem by a scholar, Lord Sainsbury. Well written. 急急忙忙苦追求，寒寒暖暖顿春秋。朝朝暮暮迎佳绩，妹妹昏昏白了头。I don't have good translation. It's just summary what it really means. This means that you are very hurry, and you try to seek every day, and you do that. Day after day, year after year. 然后朝朝暮暮迎佳绩，从早到晚就为了生活打拼。结果呢，面面昏昏白了头，结果就 无底无土的就老了，头发都白了。 So you try to make a living from day to night, from dawn to night. And without knowing that, your hair turns gray. When we are rights and wrongs, as well as afflictions and a path clearly lies ahead, yet you refuse to take. 这个讲的我们世俗的生活，世事灰飞了，烦烦恼恼，这个没有休止的时候。然后你这个明明白白的一条路就在面前，但是呢，就是万万千千，怎么样也不肯去修。 So this is an ordinary life that rises and runs, afflictions, it's never end. And yet people show you a very clear path ahead and you refuse to take. 那这个我想大家 我相信很多人也是想要出家，也知道这么一条路，但是呢，也不是说不肯修，而是怕，不敢去。So I think I believe many people would like to become a monastic, and they all know this is a right path to take. However, they don't refuse to take, they just don't have the courage, I think. 很多大家就是对未知有个恐惧，你不晓得我现在这个工作辞掉以后，出家以后会怎么样。 I think that's very common. People feel insecure. You let go with what you have right now. And you don't know if you quit a job and what's going to be, okay? So that's actually holding people back to become a monk or not. I don't have time to share with you this. Just want to talk about this. 例子我们讲说舍得了，你要，我说你要舍，才能够得。你不舍的话不能得。So you must letting go first. You must let go first before you can gain. For example, when you have a fist, make a fist like this. If someone want to give you gold or jade, you won't be able to accept, right? 那你如果有人要给你金子，或者是玉，再宝贵的东西，那你始终是把你的手掌抓得紧紧的，和一个拳头这样子，你没有办法接受人家给你的东西，要怎么样呢？你如果放开以后，你就可以有很多东西，是不是？ But if you let go your fingers, you can accept a lot of things. And what we usually do is we very afraid. We don't want to let go. You don't want to let go your job, your family, your house, everything. So this is the state most people are. Now, 我们往往就放不下，你的工作你放不下，你的家庭你放不下，那你就永远是在这个状态下，因为你怕说你手一放开以后，把这个放开以后，你什么东西都没有。So you, I think you are afraid that once you let go, you have nothing left, right? But as a matter of fact, you gain more you can gain the whole world, actually. 那实际上呢，你可得到的可以得到更多的东西。 所以必须要能够放下来，公开的。这个上人讲的嘛，你舍不了假，成不了真。This is the final words from the Vinaya Master. If you can let go of the false, you will not accomplish the true. 我们所有 生活上，我所说有违法的、梦幻泡影，我们现在所有的，这个都是假的东西。你都舍不了的话，那得不了、成不了真的东西。Whatever we have right now is all false. Right? This is all called conditioned dharma. It's all illusions. However, if you can let go of the false, you'll never attain the truth. I want to go over this quickly with people. And this is for men only. Women have a different system. 这个是适合男众，女众的话有女众的自己的一套系统。我们这是一国两制。 The first condition is that you need to be a volunteer, usually at CDDP. It can be at other branch monasteries for a 6 months. 那你至少要在万佛城或其他的分支道场当义工满了六个月。然后呢，满个六个月以后，你就可以申请进入这个 沙弥先修班当学员。 So once you fulfill this requirement as a volunteer, 6 months, then you can apply to enter the novice trainee program and become a trainee. As a trainee for 6 months, then you can apply to become a novice. 那你学员满六个月以后，若表现可以的话， 你可以申请来剃度出家，okay? So this is a very brief steps you take. Actually, it won't take that long, actually. But usually it takes longer than 6 months here, 6 months there. But within 2 years, everything goes okay, you should be able to become a novice. 那这个六个月当然是最少的呢。 但是你即使这个延到一年，这延到一年的话，你应该是2年就可以满了你这个出家的梦。Okay. So I think that's pretty much what I want to say today. And also another condition, no more than 55 years old, okay, no older than, 必须是不超过55岁。 那这些条件是在讲的，这是适合男众，女众的话的条件比较苛，而且年纪也比较上限也比较低。那我不详细的我不清楚。Again, this is just for the men's side only. The women's usually has the requirement are more strict. Okay, they need longer period of time. And also their maximum age is lower than men's. Okay. So, and I want to let people know that starting next week, we have a forum coming up. Okay. 那要让大家晓得，就是说从下礼拜开始，每天开始。 一个研讨会，这是对新冠肺炎多角度反思的一个研讨会。 This is a reflection of the COVID-19 pandemic. This from different perspectives. It's the same link as this one. 用同样的连接，就是跟今天一样连接。那这个是叶教授来，他下去筹划的，他也会组织。This is one that's organized by Dr. Ye, and he's going to be a moderator as well. I don't know whether Dr. Ye is online. If he's online, maybe he can explain to us. Lloyd, do you know if Dr. Ye is online? Okay, anyway, let me just quickly run through. This is a next week will be Dr. Ron Epstein. 那下礼拜就是易湘莲博士，然后接下来是我们当地的一个医生. This is a doctor, a local doctor. Then Nippon. This is then the 6th of December. This is a Professor Clay Brown, it's from UC Berkeley. 那这个是布朗教授，这是伯克莱大学的教授。 那到13号的话是温武清道教授, I think he is online. There's a Professor Wu, I believe he is online. 那这些演讲的人呢,他会是用英文来演讲,那我们会用中文同步翻译的方式. So these speakers will speak in English and we'll have simultaneous Chinese translation. So I think we run over time already. Don't have time for questions. We'll end here today, and before we end, we do dedicate merit. Okay. So we'll chant this in English. 那我们就来功德回向。 来唱英文。 May the merit of the spread is adorned all the Buddha's hands, repay the kindness from above and rescue those in Pepino. May all who see or hear this resolve upon awakening, and when this body meets the assembly, home together in the den of bliss. Three bows. In respect the Venerable Master. Amitabha.